Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And we see those hands go up. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So today, in Psalm 118, verse 24, it says, "This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be." So I'm seeing a lot of frowns right now. How about we turn those frowns upside down and show those 32 teeth? Come on, and show to the person next to you, on your right, on your left, and shake their hands and say, "Rejoice in the Lord always." Come on, shake their hands, say, "Rejoice in the Lord always." Big smiles, big smiles. So I want to ask you, how would you rejoice in the Lord? It's not a rhetorical question. I'm literally asking you, how would you rejoice in the Lord? Yes, okay. Anything else? Smiling, praising, jumping, dancing, singing, clapping. Excellent. How about we try some of these, okay? So right now, let's all welcome a mighty King, the Lord of Lords, the Alpha, the Omega, the Great I Am, into our presence with a big round of applause. Come on, everybody. Mega, come on, louder. Woo! Some cheering for the Lord Almighty. Hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So, wow, I believe God has felt a very nice, warm welcome from everyone here. And he's right now sitting in the front seat, front row, watching all of us. Do you believe that God, who's enthroned on our praises right now, deserves to be praised, lifted our hands and shouted praise? Do you believe? Yes. Okay. But I want to say, in Psalm 150, verse 6, it says, "Let everything that has breath..." Do you have breath in your lungs?
Yes.
So do you believe this mighty God deserves to be praised softly?
No.
So then how should you praise God?
Louder.
That's right. Loud. Shout praises. So how about we try that? Let's all raise our hands and shout praises. Come on, everybody. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Welcome into our presence, Lord Jesus. You're a mighty God. Thank you, Lord. The great I am, the Alpha, the Omega, the beginning, the end. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for being here with us today. Hallelujah. So, right now, I believe we all had dreams and goals at the start of the year, right? And maybe all of a sudden, some unexpected storm came in our life and that got disrupted. Maybe a sickness, maybe a loss of job, maybe we lost a loved one, or maybe there was a breakage of a relationship. And this caused us to be completely lost. Lost in this storm of life. But you know what? Don't worry. Who is there with us? Who is there with us? That's right. So in every place that we cannot find a way, we are completely lost and we cannot find a way. Where there's no way, God will. Can we tell a friend that? Where there's no way, God will make a way. Come on, tell a friend that. Your person on your right, on your left. So right now, how will God make a way for us? Does he control the storms? Does he control those winds? Who is the one who controls those winds? So those winds, instead of propelling us back, pushing us back, it's going to propel us forward. It's going to turn into an advantage for us. Hallelujah. Even though we're in that storm of life and we cannot see anything that's happening, all those winds are going to be shifted. God is going to change the direction and shift it in our favor. Hallelujah. I'll tell you, in the book of Acts, we see Saint Paul. He was a prisoner on a boat, okay? And he was on his way to Rome. And he was arrested because he was said that he was causing a disturbance. And this disturbance is preaching the word of God, telling people about God. This is what they call disturbance, okay? And so he was arrested and put on that boat. And he was found not guilty, but he had to still go and appeal to Caesar. So on that boat, while he was there, this is a several months journey, okay? On that way, suddenly there was literally a storm. Huge storm, like a hurricane came and was trapping all of them in that storm, battering the boat, smashing the boat right and left. And they literally, for 2 weeks, they couldn't see the sun or the stars. They didn't know where they were going. Hallelujah. They were just lost at sea. And like that, people started throwing things overboard because they started taking in water. The boat started getting water. It was like a Titanic situation. You know, and so they started throwing things overboard, the cargo and everything they could to lighten the boat. And at that time, they were going through this hardship. People started feeling desperate and despondent, and they were in despair. And the scripture says that they lost hope of ever being saved. And in that time, Paul was there. And in that storm, while Paul was there with them, an angel of the Lord appeared to him suddenly in the eye of the storm. And he said, "Paul, do not be afraid, for you will surely go and appeal to Caesar. And not just you, but everyone on the ship will be saved with you." Hallelujah. Why did that happen to just Paul? What was Paul doing different from everybody else? They were probably saying, he was not seeing any good circumstance. After that angel came, circumstance was still bad around him. Sometimes we see opposite things of what God has promised us. We're seeing, instead of health, good health, we're seeing sickness. Lord, you're giving me sickness instead of good health. I'm seeing this. Lord, you said my children will be mighty in the land, but they're falling into addictions. Lord, I was thinking of getting a promotion, but I've got a job loss. Sometimes we see this. And the same thing for Saint Paul. He's the one person who saw this all the time. But what was he doing different from everybody else? What was he doing? That's right. He was praising God in that eye of the storm. No matter what, even before the angel came, he was praising God. And he had faith. God has planned for me to go to Rome. I will definitely reach there. Hallelujah. Same thing for you and your dreams and your plans. God's plans for you are not for your disaster, but for your... Jeremiah 29:11 says that God has promised you your plans. His plans for you are for your betterment, not for any disaster. Nothing will happen to you. Praise the Lord. So no matter what, you will reach the other side. Hallelujah. So tell a friend, God will calm the storm. Come on, tell a friend. And 1 Thessalonians 5:18 says, in all circumstances, praise the Lord. In all circumstances, praise the Lord. So no matter whether it's a negative circumstance or a positive one, what are we supposed to do? So can we all try that right now? Come on, let's all lift our hands and praise this mighty God. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, despite the storm of our life, we are praising you here, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hear our praise, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. In the eye of the storm, we are praising you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah. right now, I believe all of y'all have become just like Saint Paul. Praise the Lord. Now we're going to turn into David. King David. What did King David love to do? That's right. He loved to dance. And y'all said, wonderful way to rejoice in the Lord is through. So are y'all ready? Okay, I think y'all are going to have some fun with this song. Okay, I want y'all all to follow these steps. Okay. Everybody raise your right hand. Put your right hand in. Put your right hand out. I think y'all got an idea of it. Put your right hand in and shake it all about. Now it's not do the boogie boogie, okay? We're going to instead give our heart to Jesus, okay? So put both your hands on your heart. Give your heart to Jesus and turn yourself around. Come on, everybody, turn yourself and give a big smile to the person behind you. Turn yourself around. And that is what it's all about. And that's what it's all about. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So we're going to do our right hand, our left hand, right foot and left foot. Are you all ready?
Yes.
Was that simple?
Yes.
Come on, choir. Come on.
Put your right hand in, you put your right hand out. Right hand in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus and turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Put your left.
Left hand in, you put your left hand out. Left hand in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Now we're gonna sing, give your heart to Jesus.
Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. That's what it's all about.
Come on, right foot now, we're gonna go. Come on.
Put your right foot in, you put your right foot out. Right foot in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Left foot in, you put your left foot out. Left foot in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Come on, everybody, give your heart.
Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. And that's what it's all about.
Come on, everybody, let's lift our hands and praise God. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. So, I want to tell you about another part of the Bible. Maybe some of y'all know, some of y'all don't know, okay? There was a young boy named, I had to practice saying his name, Mephibosheth. Mephibosheth, okay? Have you all heard of this name? Okay, it's a very hard name. Okay? Now, Mephibosheth is in the Bible, and he is the grandson of King Saul, and he's the son of Jonathan, King David's best friend. Now I think you'll recognize the name, right? Yeah. King David's best friend was Jonathan. And this Mephibosheth was his son, okay? He was a small boy. And I'm talking in the sense of the storm, okay? Imagine his storm, okay? This little boy, he was just on one day, okay? Suddenly, he hears his grandfather and his father got killed in the same battle on the same day. Imagine that, okay? And he's a young boy. And when the news came to his maid, there was a maid taking care of him. When it came to his maid, the maid grabbed him and she took him running away to try and hide him, because immediately they'll try and kill the son. So she took him and ran. And as she was running, she tripped and fell. And Mephibosheth fell as well. And at that moment, Mephibosheth got crippled for life in both his legs. And like that, she took him after that, and years passed. And imagine, this young boy is supposed to live as royalty. He's living in the most poorest, poverty-stricken areas, and that's his life. And after some time, you think that God has forgotten these kind of people. He felt like that. Nobody's there. God is not there. It was never his fault that all this battle took place and anything. And he was just downtrodden, left to die. That's it. His life is just in poverty. But you know what? God never forgets us. Hallelujah. So one day, King David, he was reminiscing, remembering about Jonathan, his best friend. And he said to his people, he was like, is there any relatives around of Jonathan? Are they still alive? And they said, yes, his son is there. His son is still alive. And he said, yes, go bring him. Bring him to me. And this Mephibosheth started shaking. He thought, oh my goodness, I'm going to be finished. They found me now. So this is the end of my life. I had a miserable life and I'm now going to end it. But they carried him and took him to the palace. They cleaned him up and they brought him in front of King David. And at that moment, he was thinking King David will order. He was assuming the worst. So he thought he will order him to kill him. And at that moment, King David said, from today onwards, you will live in my house. You will dine with me every day. And I will give you the land that belonged to your father and your grandfather. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's give the God a big round of applause. God will never forget you. You think his plans were to be a royal son, royalty, and he became a poverty stricken, and you think that he's written off. But God remembered him and brought him back to his place. Hallelujah. And God is going to do the same for you. Whatever plans you have, if you want to get well, if you want to see good health, it depends on what you say. If you want to be stuck in the eye of the storm, you have to keep complaining. That is what is going to happen if you want to be stuck in the eye of the storm. If you want to get out of the eye of the storm, what do you have to do? So are you all ready to praise God? So come on, everybody. Let's lift our hands and praise God. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. We're going to praise you in the eye of the storm, no matter the circumstance, Lord Jesus. No matter our circumstance, we love you, Lord Jesus. We know you've not forgotten about us. We know you've counted each and every hair on our head, Lord Jesus. You've written the name, our name, on the palm of your hand, Lord Jesus. We know we are precious in your sight, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, so I just asked so that we can do the dance one more time. Are you all ready? Okay, come on, everybody. Let's do the dance one more time. This time, we're going to add a little bit extra. We're going to be putting both our hands up. Can we both put our hands up? Shake it, shake it. Yes. Okay. And put our hands down. Okay. So this is part of one part. Okay. And then there's another verse that says, put your whole self in. Come on, everybody. Put your whole self in. And put your whole self out. And shake it all about. Okay. Are you all ready to give your heart to Jesus?
Yes.
Come on. Come on, choir.
Put your right hand in, you put your right hand out. Right hand in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Put your left hand in, you put your left hand out. Left hand in and shake it all around. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. Give your heart to Jesus. That's what it's all about.
Come on, let's put our...
Put your right foot in, put your right foot out. Right foot in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around.
Come on, everybody.
That's what it's all about.
Put your left foot in,
you put your left foot out. Left foot in and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Give your heart to Jesus.
That's what it's all about. Put your both hands up and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about.
Put your whole self in
and shake it all about. Give your heart to Jesus, turn yourself around. That's what it's all about. Give your heart to Jesus. That's what it's all about.
Come on, everybody. Let's give God a big round of applause. Yeah, hallelujah. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let's lift our hands and raise our voices. Hallelujah, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Yes, Lord. We know giving our heart to you, we will get everything that we need, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We're going to praise you in the eye of the storm. Hallelujah, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Now, Father is here. With the Blessed Sacrament, let's adore the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, my brothers and sisters. All of you can kneel down and whatever posture, please do adore the Lord. Blessed are those who have regard for the weak. The Lord delivers them in times of trouble. The Lord protects and preserves them. They are counted among the blessed in the land. He does not give them over to the desire of their enemies. The Lord sustains them on the sickbed and restores them from the bed of what? Illness. Okay, let's go back. Now, I'm going to give you the 3 points here, my brothers and sisters. You see, those who have regard for the poor, those who are concerned for the poor, those who have love for the poor and the downtrodden or the needy, there are promises attached to it. Okay, there are three mighty promises we can see in this, my brothers and sisters. The number one, in the time of the difficulty or trouble, God delivers them. Hallelujah. You know, you may be having so many problems in your life, my brothers and sisters. You see, maybe a financial problem, job-related problem, health-related issue, relationship problem, or any kind of a bondages you may be in. Or whatever your troubles, whatever your difficulties, when you call out to the Lord, He is ready to answer you because you are merciful. Hallelujah. Matthew 5:7 says, blessed are the merciful, and they shall have what? Mercy. Hallelujah. If you are merciful, God will be merciful to you. Hallelujah. That's a powerful promise, my brothers. The second promise, the Lord protects and preserves them. They are counted among the blessed in the land. He does not give them over to his enemies. Hallelujah. My brothers, that means there's a divine protection for you when you are merciful, when you are kind, when you regard for the poor. There's a divine protection is coming around you. Hallelujah. The same protection may not come to the wicked people. You see, my brothers and sisters, they lose their protection. You know, but the people who are with the Lord, who are doing righteous things, who have love for the poor people, who have regards for the poor people, that divine protection will come upon you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The third promise, my brothers and sisters, is a beautiful one. The Lord sustained them on their sick bed and restored them from their bed of illness. Hallelujah. Shall we read this all together? The Lord sustains them on their sick bed and restores them from their bed of illness. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, when you are sick, when you are merciful, God gives you top preference to heal you. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You know, I got a beautiful testimony to share with you, my brothers and sisters. You know, this happened in the life of the gentleman. His name is Leo Lobo. You know what happened to Leo Lobo? He was sick, my brothers and sisters. In the night, few days back, suddenly, you know, his children, Janet and her husband and the son is here. I'm going to introduce them later. You know, suddenly they heard a big sound. You know, and their father was always very healthy, very active member in the church. He was a lay minister in the church and in the church in India. And every year, father is to come and visit his children here during the Christmas period. As usual, he came and he was packing his bags to go back a few days back. You know, he was planning his next day was his flight was due and he was about to go. Now, that night he was sleeping, my brothers and sisters. Suddenly the sound came from the bedroom, a big sound. And they all rushed, what happened to daddy? And when they saw, their father was struggling for breath. He saw, it was a shocking for the children. And immediately they called the ambulance and they rushed him to the hospital. And my brothers and sisters, and the doctor said, oh, you have brought him the right time. He had a mild stroke, a kind of a blockage to the brain, my brothers and sisters, a small stroke to the brain. You see, the blood flow stopped, you know, and it would have been a very critical if they had delayed and if you had boarded the flight. Doctor said his chances of survival would have been difficult if he had boarded the flight. He said, because the air pressure, compression, all this height, and all this will make, you know, when there is this kind of a problem is there with the blood, and it will affect them. And he could have even died, you see. My brothers and sisters, but God was so merciful before he was about to just the night, you know, then the morning was supposed to be on the flight. My brother and sister, God showed. And because of that, they could rush him to the hospital. And doctor said, this is just a minor. And there's no surgery, nothing is required. He will recover and only medication is required. And they brought him back healthy and safe. Shall we see the two photographs here? The first one, he was on the bed. My brother and sister, can we have the photographs? Yeah, I want you to show the photographs here. He's on the bed here in the hospital. And now next to that photograph, let us watch. Here is our brother Leo Lobo. And the children are here. Janet, can you stand? And your son also is there. Shall we? This is the family. Turn around. And this is the family, my brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. And I want to tell you something here. You can be seated. Why God brought a powerful healing, and which could have become a disaster, did not become a disaster. Exactly the word on the sick bed, if you're merciful to the poor, the Lord will restore you to back to health. You see what happened? The father is a very big intercessor. He goes to the church and spends hours in front of the Blessed Sacrament and intercedes for the other people. There are so many people asking. He's a lay minister in the church. He serves the church. He comes and he sits in the front of the Blessed Sacrament. Hours he spends to pray for the needy people. That mercy, that goodness of his. And my brother and sister, God brought a powerful healing upon him. He right in at home now. He has been discharged yesterday. And he is perfectly normal today. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My brother and sister, that's why I'm trying to tell you today. You have to be merciful, compassionate. And that time, the God will restore you back to health and raise you from the sick bed. You know, that's why, my brother and sister, remember always to be merciful and kind to the poor. Okay. And the second way, my brothers and sisters, you know, in a powerful way, how faith can bring the healing. Our faith. You see, my brothers and sisters, sometimes people do not have faith. They have faith in only in doctors. They don't know there's a doctor of doctors. You can see him in the Blessed Sacrament. You know, he is the doctor of doctors. And his name is Jesus Christ. Shall we give a big hand to him in the Blessed Sacrament? Hallelujah. He can bring any healing to you, my brothers and sisters. Because he is the creator of all of us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Luke chapter 8, verse 43 to 48. Let's get into that, my brothers and sisters. Here. And a woman was there who had been subject to bleeding for 12 years. But no one could heal her. She came up behind him and touched the edge of his cloak. And immediately bleeding stopped. "Who touched me?" Jesus asked. When they all denied it, Peter said, "Master, the people are crowding and pressing against you." But Jesus said, "Someone touched me. I know that power has gone out of me." Then the woman, seeing that she could not go unnoticed, came trembling and fell at his feet. In the presence of all the people, she told why she had touched him and how she had been instantly healed. Then he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has healed you. Go in peace." Hallelujah. When Jesus was going around, do you think only 4 or 5 people were accompanying him, going around with him? Huh? No. Thousands of people. You see, flocking around him, going with him, running with him. My brothers and sisters, in between all these touches, Jesus noted one special touch. He recognized it. He said, "Who touched me?" Peter said, "Lord, there's thousands of people here. We don't know who touched you. Anybody can touch you." You think when Jesus is going around, people will not touch him? I'm asking you. Will they touch him or not? Yes. How many much have touched him? You see? But it did not make any difference. Because they did not have that kind of a faith. What this woman with a 2-hour bleeding problem What she had that faith, all those people, maybe thousands, but touch him on the his journey. But none of them got healed. But she got healed. Hallelujah. My brother, sister, because it was the touch of faith. Yes. It was the touch of faith. My brother and sister, I remember one beautiful testimony. You know, one priest was giving this testimony in Hyderabad or Secunderabad somewhere. You see, there's a retreat center, divine retreat center. You know, this particular priest one day was conducting a retreat, and he has a habit of going around with the Blessed Sacrament, carrying this monstrance, and with the Blessed Sacrament, he goes through the hall. At that time, people are touching the temple. They want to touch this Blessed Sacrament. And here it was, a lady. How she had come on a wheelchair, my brothers and sisters, on a wheelchair. And she had come all the way from Mumbai to Hyderabad to the retreat. And she was paralyzed. That's why she came on a wheelchair with someone helping her. And what happened? This lady had a great faith that God is going to heal her. You know? And with that faith, she came. And when the priest was carrying the Blessed Sacrament in that particular retreat center, you know, the thought came to her. There is no need for me, you see, to touch the monstrance or anything or the Blessed Sacrament up. Even if I touch the fringe of the cloak of the priest who is carrying Jesus on in his hands, that Blessed Sacrament, I will be healed. You see, that faith, with that faith, my brother and sister, that lady touched, when Father was passing by, she touched the fringe of his cloak. That moment, the power from this God's power moved upon her. You see, and all the places where she was paralyzed become strengthened. And she got up from the wheelchair. That very moment, she came upon the stage and testified for the glory of God. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, look at the faith of this woman. You know, believing and trusting. I did not have to even touch the Blessed Sacrament. Even if I touch the fringe of priest's cloak is enough. And she got healed. My brothers and sisters, what a faith people have. You see, that's what I'm trying to tell you, my brothers and sisters. Hebrews 11:6 says, listen to this. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. You see, my brothers and sisters, it's impossible to please God without faith. You have to believe, because anyone who comes to Him must believe that He exists, and that He rewards those who earnestly seek Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, that is why I'm telling you, you should have that faith, my brothers and sisters. I remember one of our prayer group member here, her name is Claire. One day she was sharing with me, brother, I want to tell you about my auntie who is in Australia. You know what happened to her? She was paralyzed for many years. One day there was a crusade in Australia in some place. And she with her family came to the retreat on the wheelchair. And she was sitting in the front row. And all the wheelchairs were kept. And when the preacher was conducting the session, he suddenly looked at her. Sister, he said, you are healed by the Lord, can you stand up and come on the stage? That very moment, my auntie got the strength on her legs and her body, and she walked out of the wheelchair, came on the stage, and testified for the glory of God. And then After the retreat, she was happy. She was going back with the family, walking very happily. Suddenly, she remembered she had left back her wheelchair. And she said, "Where is my wheelchair?" She looked back. "Where is my wheelchair? Where is my wheelchair?" That very moment, she got the paralysis again. And till her death, she was paralyzed. This is a real story. My brothers and sisters, that lack of faith, she should have left that wheelchair. Isn't it? My brothers and sisters, she started looking for a wheelchair. And she got paralyzed again. That's what I'm trying to tell you, my brothers and sisters. Have faith in Jesus' healing. You see, there is a power in God can do anything for you. You see, you have to have that kind of a powerful faith in Jesus. That's why James chapter 1 verses 6 to 8 says, "But when you ask, you must believe and not doubt. Because the one who doubts is like a wave of the sea, blown and tossed by the wind. That person should not expect to receive anything from the Lord. Such a person, double-minded and unstable in all they do." My brothers and sisters, you see, the person who has doubts, who doesn't believe in the power of God to heal you and bless you, is a double-minded man. He cannot expect anything good from the Lord. That's why, my brothers and sisters, Mark 11, 24 says, "When you stand for in prayer, believe whatever you have prayed for is received, and you will receive it." Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. John chapter 11, 2 Corinthians 5, 7. "For we live by," read it, "for we live by faith, not by sight." Hallelujah. Any of you seen heaven? Tell me. Not seen, no? Okay. And any of you seen hell? Somebody may say, "My house is itself is a hell." No need to real hell. Yeah. So my brothers and sisters, but we believe, right? There is heaven, there is a hell, there is Jesus. We all believe in faith. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If you believe heaven, hell, Jesus, Mother Mary, everything, angels, saints, all existing, Holy Spirit, that means you have a strong faith. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, okay. John chapter 11, verses 38 to 40. Let's get into this, my brothers and sisters. Okay. Jesus was more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. "Take away the stone," he said. "But Lord," said Martha, the sister of the dead man, "by this time there is a bad odor, for he has been dead there 4 days. Then Jesus said, "Did I not tell you, Martha, that if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" Martha did not believe. My brothers and sisters, she said, 4 days, the body must be rotting, my brothers. And Jesus is telling, open the grave. Open the, you know, push the stone aside. Open the tomb. But Jesus said, "Martha, Martha, didn't I tell you, if you believe, you will see the glory of God?" Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, lack of faith in Martha. You see, that should not happen to us. Hallelujah. If you are suffering, my brother and sister, if you are in financial problem or job-related problem, or you should not lose your faith, my brother and sister, you should believe God can do anything. He can restore you the fortunes. Hallelujah. Just now my daughter gave you a nice testimony, right? Yes. What did she tell you? You see, about Jonathan's son. What happened to him? He lost everything, right, my brothers and sisters? He was crippled, you know, but God restored everything back to him in a double fold. Praise the Lord. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. 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 My brothers and sisters, that's what I want to tell you. God can restore you back and can bless you if you have the faith. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I want to give you a beautiful testimony. I gave this 2 months back, but some of you were not there. You are absolutely new, some of you. So I want to share that testimony, but with something extra. Praise the Lord. You see, wherever there is something extra. Okay. You know. So my brothers and sisters, this happened in the life of a gentleman called Chris Dice. Few months back. You know, Chris Dice was crossing the road in Karama. Suddenly, RTA bus. You know the size of the bus, right? RTA bus? Yes. Okay. That hit him. Can you believe a bus of that magnitude can hit a person and that person can be saved? Very less chances. My brothers and sisters, now Chris immediately fell down and went into coma. And what all things happened? Can we put those all kinds of wounds, hurts he had? I want to see on the screen. Do we have that on the PPT? Yes, I want to see that. You know, I want to read it out for you. Some of the things that this Chris had. Because my brothers and sisters, he had such a terrible wounds all over the body. He had brain got affected. He had shoulders got affected. He had neck got affected. He had got all the top areas. There are so many medical terms in this. You see, that's all got affected. You know, and the chance of survival almost nil. 17 days he was in induced coma. 17 days. You see, my brothers and sisters, but his wife came, Maria, from India, all the way here. You know, and she was beside the bedside of her husband. And what she had a great faith. She said, my husband will live. You see, to back it up, she started praying, spending time with Jesus, going to the Blessed Sacrament, praying there. My brothers and sisters, you know, with a great faith, she said, my husband will live. Even though he was in coma in that state, literally given up faith by the doctors. You see, they are given up. And here, Maria is telling, he will live. My brothers and sisters, this was something beautiful. And then, what happened? Is there a, can we have that? Yes. Can you see this? I cannot read, you have to read. Okay. So all the names of this, yes. Can someone read? Yeah. You can read, right? All the wounds what he had, it's all over here. You can see all that is, you know, these are the things he had in the hospital. You can see his state in the hospital here, my brothers and sisters. Chris was in this state. And my brothers and sisters, what happened? And then I called Maria, I prayed over her in the hospital, you know, online. And I told Maria, you should come to the Blessed Sacrament for the healing session on the October 24th. I was conducting a session here. You see, I told Maria, you should be here and we are all going to pray for you. I'm going to lift a prayer in front of all the people for the healing of your husband. And Jesus can do anything. Everything is possible for him. And Maria obediently came with our team member. And she was here sitting and standing. And during the adoration, my brothers and sisters, I lifted a prayer and I told all the people, lift your hands and pray for Chris. And everyone gathered here and I introduced her and said, his wife is here. Every one of you pray. Every one of the people lifted their hands and with tears in their eyes were praying. My brothers and sisters, what a glorious way. Next morning onwards, Chris started improving. Tremendous improvement. You know, the doctors may be astonished the speed he was recovering, because usually with this kind of wounds and head injuries, people go into, you know, they can become vegetable, they say, right? It's a paralyzed state. Literally, they are useless, they become. But here, He recovering in a super fast way. And my brother and sister, within no time, Chris was out of the hospital. And he spoke to me. I was so happy. You see the wonder Jesus did. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, the greatest wonder of wonder is, I want to ask Chris to come on the stage here. Chris, can you come here? Hallelujah. This is Chris. And my brothers and sisters, this is Chris. Hallelujah. You see, shall we give a big hand to the Lord? He was literally dead, my brothers and sisters. And he's alive, strong, healthy. And you're joining the job, right? When? Next week he's joining the job back. Hallelujah. What a wonderful miracle. All the people prayed for you who are here that day. You want to thank them.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I would like to thank Michelle Rodriguez and Maria Fernandez. And thank you, everyone, for praying for me. And I'm back again into this. Thank you, everyone.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you, Chris, and keep you strong and healthy. You see, my brothers and sisters, it's the absolute miracle of the Lord. Hallelujah. So Jesus is living in this blessed sacrament, my brothers and sisters. You understand? That's why I called her Maria, because she had that faith, my husband will live. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, that's why faith can move the mountains. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And my brothers and sisters, and Matthew 14, 25 to 29, let's get into that, my brothers and sisters. You see, Matthew, 14, 25. Shortly before dawn, Jesus went out to them walking on the lake. When the disciples saw him walking on the lake, they were terrified. It's a ghost, they said, and cried out in fear. But Jesus immediately said to them, take courage, it is I, don't be afraid. Lord, if it's you, Peter replied, tell me to come to you on the water. Come, he said. Then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus. I did not continue. You all know what happened, right? Future story. Okay. So, why I am putting it off over there? You see, my brothers and sisters, the great thing about Peter, he took the courage to walk on the water, which none of the disciples did. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. With that faith, my brother and sister, he walked. Has anybody walked on the water? Anybody walked? Only Jesus, yes. Praise God. You see, my brothers and sisters, but Peter walked. Hallelujah. You see, my brother, we should appreciate his courage, isn't it? Yeah, we should appreciate his desire to walk and move, my brothers and sister. That's what we have to do, my brothers and sister. Put your foot ahead. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, go ahead with that faith in Jesus, my brothers and sisters, just like Peter. But don't look this side, that side, okay? But look at only Jesus. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, I want to give you a beautiful testimony, but I want to show you on the screen. It's about Shirley Williams, one lady, and just watch it, and then I'll explain to you a little bit, with those who do not understand American accent. Okay? All right. Okay. Let's watch it.
No one wants to get the kind of phone call Shirley Williams got from her doctor.
Oh, she said, Shirley, you are eaten up with cancer. You have cancer not only in your breast, but it's metastasized into your bones, into your organs, into your lymph nodes. I thought, how could this be? God, I've served you all of my life. God, how? I don't understand. Why?
Shirley had been having chest pains and feeling weak and foggy for some time. She rarely went to the doctor, but when the aches and pains didn't go away, she decided to get checked out. What followed was a barrage of tests that revealed Shirley had stage 4 cancer. It was untreatable, and she had only 90 days to live. For her husband, Mark, questions began racing through his mind.
What if Shirley
died, and what about the kids, and where am I going to be? What am I going to do? And I'm going, this can't be. I need the scriptures, because that was the only place I could dig that I could find encouragement. And I told her, Shirley, whose report are we going to believe? I said, God's word says that we shall live and not die. And Shirley, it also says that no weapon formed against us will prosper. And by his stripes, we are healed.
In the days that followed, the pain kept getting worse.
I could barely walk. My left hip was hurting so bad. The tumor in my right breast was about half the size of my fist. The pain had reached levels that I had never experienced before. There were thoughts that crossed my mind that it would just be easier to just lay down and die.
But Shirley refused to give in to fear. Instead, she and Mark decided to live by faith and speak not a single word of doubt.
I never found one place in the scriptures where someone came to Jesus for healing that they were not healed. I began to see that faith was not just believing that God was able, but it was believing that He will.
So she sought God for direction. And Shirley says one night she woke up from a deep sleep and saw Jesus at the foot of her bed.
And as I saw Him, I saw a compassion, I saw love, I saw hope. I began to feel sweat behind my right knee. And it was so unusual. And I looked at Him and I said, Lord, are you telling me to sweat?
3 days later, Shirley got her answer when she went to see a new oncologist.
I told her to pray for a miracle.
And then he said, Shirley, I've got a word for you before you leave.
I told Shirley was that she needs to sweat.
Shirley started intense sweat therapy, including detox, saunas, and lots of exercise. She also went on a strict organic diet. Meanwhile, her friends and church family fasted and prayed for supernatural healing. Mark prayed and laid hands on Shirley regularly.
Jesus said, you shall lay hands on the sick in my name, and they shall recover. And so I did that by just sheer faith, and I commanded the pain to cease in the name of Jesus.
Then 3 weeks after learning she had cancer, Shirley had a dream. She was standing behind a glass window. Coming straight at her was an overloaded, out-of-control semi.
I just began to cry out, Jesus! 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 And as I did, I remember seeing this truck coming, and then all of a sudden it tapped the glass right in front of me. And the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me, and He said, that's the cancer that I just stopped.
For the next 2 months, Shirley continued with treatments, believing that God was healing her. Soon, the good days started outweighing her bad days. And when she went in for her 90-day checkup, she got the news she'd been praying for.
The PET scan showed that the tumor was gone. At least was no evidence that there was cancer in her body. I believe that when a person has a stage 4 cancer and the cancer is gone, it's a miracle.
I was jumping, excited, twirling, thanking the Lord, just thanking God that He is a restorer.
I felt free on the inside, free to plan again, free to know that God was including her and I together for the rest of our days here on earth.
Since that August in 2012, Shirley's had no sign of cancer.
It's been amazing to know that there's true life, and there really is freedom from sickness and disease. There really is freedom from pain.
Shirley and Mark give all the credit to Jesus Christ.
I've been healed today because I believed His word, and I took it, and it had to become part of every cell of my being. He's not a respecter of persons. What He did for me, He will do for others.
Hallelujah. I believe every one of you understood this accent and the testimony, right? Hallelujah. Just given 90 days to live, but my brother, and fourth stage cancer disappeared. Hallelujah. the faith in Jesus and the word of God, my brothers and sisters, and some of the word I'm going to give it to you. Psalm 118 verse 17. Let's get into that, my brothers and sisters. I will not die but live and will proclaim what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. And again the scripture, Isaiah 54, 17, which this brother over there was quoting. No weapon formed against you will prevail, and you will refute every tongue that accuses you. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and this is their vindication from me, declares the Lord. Hallelujah. Isaiah 53, 5, but he was pierced for our transgression. He was cursed for our iniquities. The punishment that was brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, that's why she lived by faith. Hallelujah. That's why, my brothers and sisters, that's why I'm telling you, God can do everything. Hallelujah. Let's get into Matthew chapter 9, verses 27 to 30. As Jesus went on from there, two blind men followed him, calling out, have mercy on us, son of David. When he had gone indoors, the blind men came to him, and he asked them, do you believe that I'm able to do this? Yes, Lord, they replied. Then he touched their eyes and said, according to your faith, let it be done to you. And the sight was restored. Jesus warned them sternly, see that no one knows about this. My brothers and sisters, according to your faith, let it be done to you. And what happened? The result? Result? The eyes opened because they had faith. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. If they had no faith, their eyes wouldn't have opened. My brothers and sisters, this is very important. You see, for your healing, you should believe our God is, you know, capable of doing any healing. I want to give a beautiful testimony from, you know, what happened to one family. There was a one brother called Alvaro and Celia in our prayer group. And they were very much with us, my brothers and sisters here. You know, regularly coming to the prayer gathering. They went back to Goa. And brother Alvaro was very active. He was a lay minister in the church also. Very active man. Some of you must be knowing him. You know, their niece, you know, her name is Kimberly. One day, they were traveling somewhere. She and her brother met with a very serious accident. You know, the car was literally smashed. I want to show the photograph. Shall we put the photograph of the car? You see? My brothers and sisters, this is the state of the car, my brothers and sisters. Look at the car. You see the completely scrap. You know? And her brother was driving the car, was sitting on the side where the mighty damage is there. And he came out not a scratch on his body. Hallelujah. Because this family was always in prayer and the presence of God. And Kimberly got, you know, a fracture, you know, on her right thigh, you know, bone. And she had to go on the bed for 3 months bed rest. And after that, the bone was not calcifying. That means not getting joint. You know, doctors said, initially she had one operation. Then doctors said, we have to go in for the second operation. And this family started praying the chaplets of divine mercy and continuously adoration of 3 o'clock adoration. And they asked us to pray here, my brothers and sisters, because this family knows us very well here. And we were all interceding for this Kimberly, my brothers and sisters. And doctors decided to go in for the second test before the operation. And my brothers and sisters, that results showed the scan, she is completely healed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Can we see Kimberly there? And yes, Kimberly is there. The photograph is she's in a lecturer in one of the colleges, you know, in somewhere in India. My brothers and sisters, and she's perfectly all right now. She can walk up, she can do many things, and she's doing absolutely, she's perfect. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters, our God is a mighty God. So we need to believe and trust in faith. My brothers and sisters, how do you get the faith? You see, my brothers and sisters, Romans 10:17 says, "Very faith comes by hearing the word." Hallelujah. I'm sure as you're listening to the word of God, which I preach, many of your faith has increased, right? Hallelujah. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yes, my brothers and sisters. And look at some of the scriptures I want to give you. You know, this is very important for your faith, my brothers and sisters. You know, this is very important. Matthew 9, Jesus looked at them and said, with man this is impossible, but with God all things are possible. You have to understand that. Maybe you are having a financial problem, job-related problem, health-related issues, or cancer in your body. Whatever may be, my brothers and sisters, don't underestimate God. You understand? For Him, everything He can solve your problem. My brothers and sisters, that's why you need to have that faith. My God is capable of solving my problem. Hallelujah. And the second scripture, my brothers and sisters, Jeremiah 32:27. I am the Lord, the God of all mankind. Is anything too hard for me? No, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now today God is calling you. He's in this blessed sacrament, my brothers and sisters. He's living here. In this blessed sacrament, don't underestimate His power, His glory. You know, come to me, all you labor who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. The Lord is calling you today to Him. You see, my brother, do not stay back. Come to Jesus. And my brother, sister, again, the Lord is talking to us. 1 Peter 5:7. Read this, all of you. Say this. Cast all your anxiety on Him because He cares for you. Hallelujah. Because He cares for every one of you, He cares for you. That's why shall we give a big hand to our Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We are in the presence of the Blessed Sacrament, my brothers and sisters. This is the time to adore the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament. And as I told you, cast your burden on Him because He cares for you. He is here, my brothers and sisters, in this Blessed Sacrament. Jeremiah 31:3, the Lord says, I have loved you with an everlasting love. My brothers and sisters, God's love is everlasting. Human love is temporary, my brothers and sisters. Remember, this Lord is here in this Blessed Sacrament. His love is everlasting. No human being can love you everlastingly, my brothers and sisters. It's only this God who is in this Blessed Sacrament. He loves you everlastingly. Today is the day to surrender your pain, your suffering, your misery, your agony, your loneliness, your sickness, whatever you may be suffering, my brothers and sisters, surrender to Jesus. He's going to heal you. He's going to bless you today. He's going to deliver you today. His presence will bring you joy. David said, Psalm 16:11, there's a fullness of joy in your presence, O God. Psalm 84:10, David said again, one day in your courts is better than 1,000 elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper at the house of my Lord than being in the company of the wicked. My brothers and sisters, there are so many people out there in the world, their company can be wicked. They will not be giving you joy. Maybe they are looking for joy in the drugs or alcohol and so many things of the flesh. But there will not be a fullness of joy. The only fullness of joy will give you this Jesus in the Blessed Sacrament. Isaiah 54:10, the Lord says, the mountains may go away, the hills may totter, but my everlasting love will never leave you. My covenant of peace will always be with you. My brothers and sisters, what a powerful word He's speaking to us today. Yes, He's here in this Blessed Sacrament. Isaiah 43:1-4, the Lord says, I have redeemed you, fear not. When you pass through the water will not sweep over you, because I will be with you. When you go through the fire will not burn you. The flames will not consume you, because I will be with you. have given up the whole nations to save you, because you are precious and honored in my sight, and I love you. The Lord is telling you, I love you. Yes, my brothers and sisters, God's love no human being can ever comprehend. Remember the time, Luke chapter 15, the prodigal son squandered all the wealth of his father, came back when he could not get food even from the pigs. He was upset. He remembered his father's house. Even servants are better than me here in my father's house. And when he was coming, father did not care in what state he had come. He looked from a long distance towards his son, ran all the way, hugged him, kissed him, gave a mighty banquet in his honor, welcomed him. In the same way today, when you come back to Jesus, the same reception, the same joy, he will give it to you, my brothers and sisters. Today the Lord is going to give you the same joy, same happiness when you come back to him. Do not delay your coming back if you're not with the Lord. If you're in any kind of a bondage, surrender that to Jesus today. Tell him, Lord, I'm coming back. He will take you. He will hug you. He will kiss you. There will be rejoicing in heaven. Luke 15:7 said they're rejoicing in heaven over one repentant sinner by the angels of God. Just imagine, my brothers, you know, one repentant sinner. So today, if you are that sinner, what a rejoicing will be in heaven when you repent. So today is the time to repent. This is the time to come back to the Lord. Let's worship the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament with this beautiful hymn, Draw Me Close to You. And let us draw close to Jesus today as we sing this beautiful hymn.
La 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 la
Jesus is touching you right now. His presence is here. Keep worshiping the Lord. Keep praising the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Philippians chapter 2 verses 8 to 11 says, Jesus humbled himself even to the point of death on a cross. That's why the Almighty God raised him and given him the name above all names. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow in heaven, on earth, and in the underworld. And every tongue shall confess Jesus Christ is the Lord, for the glory of God. Yes, my brothers and sisters, He is the living God. He is the living God.
Hallelujah.
So now let's repent with this small prayer of repentance. Repeat after me. Lord Jesus,
Lord,
I am a miserable sinner. I am unworthy to stand in your holy presence. Forgive me, Lord Jesus. Wash me with your precious blood and sanctify me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth and believe in my heart that you are my Lord, you are my Savior. Send forth your Holy Spirit upon me right now and change my life. Let me not be the same again. Thank you, Jesus. Praise you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Halamashila. Lapa Halamashila. Ula mama Halamashila. Lapa Halamashila. Ula mama Halamashila. Hallelujah. 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 Ula mama Halamashila. Jesus, in the Blessed Sacrament, I lift up to your special prayer, Lord, today for the children, Lord Jesus, who are appearing for the final exam. Bless these children, Lord Jesus. Give them the wisdom, Lord, to study well, Lord Jesus. And let them excel in their studies, my Lord Jesus. Give the strength to the families also, Lord Jesus, to help these children, my Lord Jesus. And let your blessing be upon these children, everyone attending the final exams, Lord Jesus. Your presence be there, my Lord Jesus, with them. Your Holy Spirit be there with them, my Lord Jesus. Father, this special prayer we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Every one of you lift your hands and praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. All those who have got a financial problem, job-related problem, I'm going to lift a prayer for you. Then all of will praise. Lord, I bring before you every one of, Lord, oh, those who are having a problem of jobs, Lord, those who have got a financial problem, Lord, all those who are going through, Lord Jesus, all these kind of problems, Lord, you solve the problem and bless their jobs, Lord, bless their finances, Lord. Those who have lost the job, all those who are seeking the job, let them get a beautiful job, Lord Jesus. Everyone with a financial problem, let there be a breakthrough for them, my Lord Jesus. Father, this special prayer we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Ula mashila la baba hala mashila. Ula mama hala mashila la 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 baba hala mashila. Ula mama hala mashila. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Ula mama. Hallelujah. All those people who are having the sicknesses in your body, my brothers and sisters, I'm going to lift a prayer for you. And as you are praying, lift your hands and praise God. And lest as I lift the petition, after that we will praise God. Lord, I bring before you everyone who is sick here, Lord Jesus, or their family members, those who are going to, especially psychological problems or all kind of emotional problems, Lord, your sicknesses, Lord. All those who are going to physical sicknesses, my Lord Jesus. All those who are going to spiritual sicknesses, Lord Jesus. or any kind of a mental illnesses, Lord Jesus, or any kind of a sicknesses in the body, Lord Jesus, or they may be suffering from the critical illnesses, Lord Jesus. Right now, Lord, as we are praying, Lord, and pleading with you, you bring forth a powerful healing upon them, Lord. Father, this special prayer we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Ula mashila la 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 ma 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 hala mashila. Ula ma 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 ma. If any of you are in the bondage of alcoholism, drug addiction, or any kind of pornography, watching pornography, or any kind of illicit relationship, right now bring before every kind of a bondage you are in, and we are going to pray and ask the Lord to heal you in this area and set you free, my brother, because Jesus is the one who can set you free. Or if you are going to have any suicidal tendencies or any of those bondages you are in, right now pray for that and God will bring a healing upon you. Lord, I bring before everyone, Lord, whoever has got the problem of the bondages in their life, my Lord Jesus. So any kind of a bondage that they may be in, Lord, right now you bring a healing to them. As they are praying to you, my Lord Jesus, you bring a healing to your children, Lord. Father, this special prayer we ask in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Ula mashila, ula mama 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 hala mashila, la 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 la. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Surrender every area. Ula mama 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 mama. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Ula mashila, hallelujah. Let's sing the beautiful hymn, "All to Jesus I Surrender." Any area, my brother and sister, right now surrender to Jesus as we sing the beautiful hymn, "All to Jesus I Surrender." Let's join and sing this hymn and surrender our life to Jesus. Surrender all again. Let's sing this, my brothers and sisters. Kidney problem be healed, uterus problem be healed, ula ba
Eyes are be healed. Leg pain be healed. In the name of Jesus, right now he's touching you. Leg pain be healed. Frozen shoulders be healed in the name of Jesus. Diabetes be healed. Liver disease be healed. Every disease be healed in the name of Jesus. Right now, let's sing the beautiful Holy Spirit, come with your fire. Holy Spirit is here. Let's sing the beautiful hymn. Holy Spirit, come with your fire.
Father is here with the blessed sacrament, my brothers and sisters. As we are in the, let's adore him as he is in the blessed sacrament. The wonderful God is here.
As you are kneeling down, genuflect, Those who are able, you can just bow or prostrate. Receive the blessings from the Lord instead of the benediction. Now we just in front of the Blessed Eucharist, either prostrate, let our forehead touch the floor so as to receive the blessing to our entire bodies. May the Lord touch you, heal you, strengthen you, protect you, and inspire you. Amen.
Special request my for prayer, my brothers and sisters. Today, John Quilby, one of our very dedicated member of our team, my brothers and sisters, brother-in-law passed away in France. And so let us pray for his soul. I'm going to lift a small prayer. Heavenly Father, I bring before you John Quilby in a very special way, Lord. We pray for the salvation of his soul, Lord. Let your great divine mercy come upon his family, my Lord Jesus, to bear this great grief which has come upon them, Lord. Father, this special prayer we ask in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, have mercy upon the soul of John Quilby, my Lord. Have mercy upon his soul, my Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. Today, my brothers and sisters, I believe Lord has touched every one of us in a very special way. Will you lift your hands and testify for that? Yes, hallelujah. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. Okay, I just want to ask you one thing now. Maybe you are sick and you had come with a headache or body ache or pain in your body and you are feeling very depressed or whatever it is. You had some problem, my brother, and you came here. Today you felt the relief. Today you have felt you have been healed. So can you all lift and your hands? Don't hesitate. You are in the presence of God, testifying for His glory. Because every testimony brings glory to God, and we all should give glory to God. So whoever felt the touch of the or any kind of a sickness you had, you felt today you are healed. Can you lift your hands? 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 All those, there are so many of you, my brothers and sisters, God has touched you and healed you today. Let's give a big hand to the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 What a joy to be healed by the Lord in a powerful way. Some people must have some vision today of any of you, maybe the angels or Jesus or Mother Mary or some the power of the Holy Spirit or some rays you saw today. Any of you saw any of the vision today as you are praying? Can you lift your hands? Any of you saw any kind of a, yes, sister, you saw some vision, yes? And what else, anybody else saw the, any? Yes, you also saw, what did you say, sister? Divine mercy, she saw and keeping the hand upon her head. Shall we give a big hand to the Lord? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Yeah, the newcomers, after you have to let on, you have to stand for a moment and lift your hands at least. When we will give the leaflet, that time Blessed Sacrament came, we couldn't give you the leaflets. So they are all ready, right? So give the this thing. So my brother and sister, God has done marvelous things. Those who have come for the first time and stood here, can you lift your hands for a moment? Yes, they are all those newcomers. Can you give and distribute? Some people can help. Quickly, Norman, can you please take the envelopes and give these people? Keep your hands lifted up, please. Quickly, quickly, quickly. Yes, yeah. Yeah, and the slip also. See the brothers, yeah, please lift your hands. Those who are not. Got it. Keep your hands lifted up. We cannot see. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Here also, see? No, yeah. Sunil, you can see this brother here. He's lifted a hand. And some of you did not lift your hands. Okay, that sister there. There, you know. Okay, those who are not got the envelope, please lift your hands, please, yeah. Okay, and write your telephone number and your name and give it to all the volunteers, okay? And also, I would like to inform you, please don't come only for the healing session. Every week we have prayer session, 8 o'clock in the evening up to 9:30, 1.5 hours. God does healing in every session. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So do come, and definitely God is going to bless you. And in a mighty number of people have come today. God bless you all, my brothers and sisters. Let's all join in and sing this beautiful hymn as we join in and rejoice in the Lord. These are the days of
Elijah.
Hallelujah. These are the days of Elijah. Yes. Okay, let's join in.
These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. These are the days of the servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And these are the days of great trial, of famine and darkness and storm. Since we are the ones in the desert, crying, preparing the way of the Lord. Behold, He comes, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun. At the trumpet call, lift your voice. It's our victory. Out of Zion till salvation comes. There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Salvation comes out of silence.